If you're ready to get primal and move like your ancestors, let's get into it. Hands under the shoulders, knees under the hips, toes tucked. As I inhale, I shift my shoulders over my fingers, and as I exhale, I shift my hips back towards my heels. So continue this flow for a little bit, stretching the wrists, stretching our feet. So this is an intermediate practice. Before I continue that thought, go ahead and flip your fingers towards your knees if that feels good, and just shift back towards your heels. Feel that good stretch. Further away your hands are from your body, the more of a stretch you're gonna feel, and vice versa. But this is an intermediate practice, so listen to your body. Now we're bringing the butts of our wrists together, fingers spread wide, two circles each direction. You can keep the toes untucked if that feels nice to you right now. So once you've done two circles on each side, we're gonna come onto a seat. Moving into our crab position. So my fingers are gonna face away from my body, thumbs out. Move my hips towards my heels, into my wrists, and then I find that center position. From there, I bridge up into a crab, and then I come back down. So we're just gonna do a few crab pulses, crab bridges if you like to call it that. And just notice as you're stretching your hips up, you're also stretching your shoulders, stretching the fronts of your hips. Just getting everything nice and loose. Now we can add some locomotion with this crab, put some life into this crab. And just going a distance of about 3 to 5 yards forward and back. Getting everything active. If you want to make it more challenging, you lift your hips up towards the sky. Very nice. Take your time and move into a low lunge position. Either the right foot or left foot to start in the very front. Back knee is down. As I inhale, I shift forward, tuck my tailbone under my hips. And as I exhale, I shift back into a half split. And one more time going forward on this side. Option to open up the left arm if your right leg is forward. And then exhale, press back into your half split. Create some space for your practice. This is gonna be a quick practice. Go ahead and switch sides. Same thing, inhale forward, exhale back, 2 times on this side. With it being a quick practice, it doesn't mean to just blaze through it half-mindedly. It's very important that we move with grace, strength, and attention to detail. One more time in the half split. Good, so we have 4 moves we're gonna work through today. Starting off in our downward facing dog position. So you're gonna tuck those toes from tabletop, reach those hips to the sky, create a little space in your down dog first. From your down dog, bring your right leg to the sky and tap it into a pigeon very briefly, bring it back to the sky and then open to wild thing. Swinging back over with grace, staying in the right side, tap and lift and swing over. Again, make sure this feels good to you. Tap in the front and the wrist. And you notice if you look with your eyes, especially on the transition back, find your hand and then switch sides. So now we switch, tapping the ground right by our wrist, and then we go up and over to wild thing. Hips high, really reach with those fingertips. Good, moving with control. How graceful can you transition? You notice we're moving in all types of ways right now in just one exercise here. Very good. For our second move here, we're gonna get to our feet. So from stand, I primal squat all the way down, knees forward with control, untuck the toes and recline. So it's a combination of strength, and mobility. If you need to use your hands as you press up and as you let yourself down, please do so. Or you need to use a chair or a couch or a countertop to the side of you, feel free to do that as well. Again, take your time, stay with your breath. If your breath is all out of control, then we need to slow it down even more. This is one of my favorite ways to start the day, moving my body in all different types of creative ways. So for our last move, we're gonna grab our yoga block if you need. You may not need a block. You can also use a book, and you can also use a chair. So we're moving from warrior three to half moon. So with yoga block in hand, I'm starting off in my warrior three, opening up into airplane mode, and then I transition to half moon. So spending about 2-3 seconds in each pose before I transition back out. So today we're gonna do 3 transitions on each leg. Get everything going. This is also a really good warm-up. If you're an athlete or if you're about to work out and do some strenuous work, or maybe you want some active recovery, this is really good. Once you've done 3, we're gonna switch sides. So switching hands, maybe there's a focal point on the floor that you wanna look at. Find that airplane of choice. And transition to your half moon with grace. Not only are we moving with grace in terms of our body being in control, moving fluidly, but also giving yourself grace if you lose your balance. This is practice. We're not performing for anybody. So you'll even see me wiggle my knees a little bit of wobble right here. Stay with it. This is all part of the practice. One more time. Once you finish 3, you can shake it out and take a break. We'll move into our cool down. Very nice. As you keep practicing these moves on your own, they will get easier and easier. It doesn't take a lot of time. Very good. Now let's take a seat and let's loosen up these hips for our cool down. Let's start with our 90 degree hip flow. Toes up, heels down. Starting off, moving one way, get the stretch on one side. Say hello to your child. He just woke up. He was not about that life. Not trying to open those hips this early. Plus, his hips are probably already wide open. Let's just be real. Okay, a couple more times. What's funny is I show my kid, who in this video is 2 and a half years old, and this is just second nature to him. He could do all this stuff in his sleep. Good. Just relaxing down, cooling down. Let your heart rate start to slow. Let your breathing deepen. Last but not least, let's work our shoulders. Let's get those bad boys open. So you can use your block as a pillow. You don't need to use a block here. I'm gonna tuck my knees in. I'm laying on my right side. My left hand on top is going to trace a big circle overhead, touching the ground with my fingers for as long as humanly possible. Again, every day is different. Each side of your body is gonna be different. So move slow. We're just doing 3 big circles on each side. If your fingers don't touch the floor at any point or even at all, it's very important that you don't force your fingers down. Whatever's available to you today will work with that. Once you've done three on one side, we'll balance it out on the other side. You may have noticed on my right shoulder, I have KT tape. I had recently strained my shoulder, my rotator cuff, pretty bad 2 weeks ago, and I could not do this move for sure. But through animal flow, through yoga, through my own knowledge, I'm a personal trainer, so I know a lot of rehab work, rotator cuff work, and then a combination of going to physical therapy and chiropractic sessions. In 2 weeks of just moving my body and just moving in general has helped me a lot. So hope it does the same for you. Have a beautiful day, and I'll see you next time.